everyone. Today we are preparing an income and expenditure account. I hope you remember in the previous video we did how do we prepare a receipt and payment account. This is the next step of in the preparation of books of accounts of NPO. In previous video we did that we need to prepare receipt and payment account, secondly income and expenditure account, and then a balance sheet to fully compile our books of accounts in case of NPO. This is the same data which we have used in the preparation of receipt and payment account. With the very same data we are going to prepare an income and expenditure account. First of all, what is the difference between the two? We use some terminologies like cash receipt and cash payment may be pertaining to the previous year, current year or the coming year when we talked about receipt and payment account. But this is totally different, right? In income and expenditure account, we try to find out surplus or deficit. This is same like a PL account. Why are we not using the terminology profit and loss account then? Because profit and loss account is used for those organizations which work for the purpose of earning profit, right? An NPO doesn't work for the purpose of earning profit. It works for social cause. So the terminologies used here are surplus or deficit, right? Just like a PL, we record all the income and expenses here. How do we prepare an income and expenditure account with the help of receipt and payment account? A receipt and payment account shows all the cash which has flown in and all the cash that has flowed out in a particular year, right? With the help of that, we have to now find out whether NPO has earned surplus or is the NPO is it in deficit now, right? We pick up the items. Secretary's remuneration, it's an expense, right? So we will record it here below the heading of expenditure. All the expenses have been recorded here. Next, subscription was our income then. We have recorded it here in income column. Entrance fees, admission fees, lockers rent, general donation. Looking on the two, the receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account, some items might be missing here. What are those items? Opening cash and closing cash is missing here. Why? Because that was a receipt and payment account, it was recording all the cash that has flown in, right? And all the cash that has flowed out, and it was also recording the opening and closing cash balances. Whereas this is not, it is not like a cash book, that was like a cash book. This is like a PL. Does a PL record opening cash? No. Or a closing cash? No. All those figures flow into a balance sheet. They are shown in a balance sheet. So we have not shown any opening cash and closing cash here. The main aim to prepare this income and expenditure account is to find out the surplus or deficit. So we will record only revenue nature items here. Why am I putting this point is that because that investment of rupees 2200 is missing here, which was shown in the receipt and payment account. Why was it reflecting there then? It was reflecting there because we had paid 2200 for the purpose of investment. So cash was flowing out. But is that revenue in nature? No, that is a capital nature item. It will be shown in our balance sheet. That will reflect in our balance sheet on the asset side. That is not an expense. Neither is that an income nor is that an expense, that it will reflect here, right? So that cost of investment of 2200 will not appear in this. Opening cash and closing cash will not appear in this. The very main purpose, the aim of preparing this is to find out the surplus figure. Right, so we will record only revenue nature items here. No capital nature items will be recorded. First, very important point. Next important point. In receipt and payment account, we were recording all that cash which has flown in. Maybe that belongs to previous year, current year or coming year. But when we prepare a profit and loss account, right, in case of all those organizations which are working for the purpose of earning profit, we record only those items which belong to the current year, because that is the main aim of preparation of P&L account. We have to find out the profit earned or the loss suffered for a particular year. In the same manner, we are preparing this income and expenditure account. The main aim is to find out whether an NPO, whether an NPO has earned surplus or whether that NPO has suffered any deficit. So we will record only those items which belong to current year, right? So we do not record those items which belong to previous year or those items which belong to the coming year. Suppose this advance fee of 1200, suppose there is a twist in question. I say that this 1200 is this whole figure doesn't belong to this year. In this 1200, 200 is the amount for previous year and 100 is the advance. 100 is advance, that is, it belongs to the coming year. So what is that value which you are going to put here as income? We will say from rupees 1200, this is a working note, from rupees 1200, this is the cash. This 1200 is the cash which you have received this year, which was appearing on the receipt side. But this full amount is not our income. Why? Because 200 belongs to previous year and we are recording the income for the current year only, right? So we subtract rupees 200 because it belongs to previous year. We also subtract rupees 100. Why? Because it belongs to the coming year. It doesn't belong to current year. So what is the income for this year? Income for this year is rupees 900 only, right? So we will not record 1200 here. We will record only 900. This is just a basic question. There are no twists and turns like this. Like the questions like this we'll do in further videos. This is a basic question in which we are preparing income and expenditure account from a very basic receipt and payment account. It doesn't showcase all these twists and turns, right? This was just a basic question in which we have prepared an income and expenditure account from a very basic receipt and payment account. The main aim of doing this question is to understand what is the difference between a receipt and payment account and income and expenditure account. These are the variations. These variations we are going to learn in further videos, right? The main aim today is just to find out that difference, that demarcation between a receipt and payment account and a income and expenditure account. Come on, let's revise those points. A receipt and payment account is like a cash book. We record all the money, all the cash that has flown in and all the cash that has flown out, right? That cash may belong, that money may belong to previous year, may belong to current year, it may belong to the coming year, right? What happens in case of income and expenditure account when we prepare an income and expenditure account? It is not a cash book. Cash book, like a cash book, was our receipt and payment account. The main aim here is to find out the surplus or deficit. It is a sort of PL account. Why are we not using PL account then? This terminology, why are we not using this terminology of profit and loss account? Because that is used for organizations which work for the aim of earning profit. And NPO doesn't work for the purpose of earning profit, right? So terminology is income and expenditure account. Here we record all the expenditures. Here we record all the incomes. Expenditures belonging to current year only. Incomes belonging to current year only. Right? So switching from a receipt and payment to income and expenditure account, we have to change our mindset. There we were recording all previous, current, coming. Here we are recording only current items, right? Belonging to current year. There we were recording revenue and capital nature both. Here we are recording only revenue nature item. Why? Because the main aim is to find the surplus or the